So good afternoon, you guys. So today I'm gonna use the movie The Matrix, the trilogy of The Matrix, just a little bit of my breakdown of it to get you to understand how your emotions and your consciousness has to come into play together, how they have to come together and come in unison with one another in order for you to create the life that you desire to create. So just to give you a brief little understanding, in the movie The Matrix, Neo, the One, he represents the power of your will to shape the world around you, your will to be, to not be contoured to the world, but to contour the world to you. That's what he represents. Trinity, she represents the heart, your emotions, your feelings. The sacred feminine is what Trinity represented. And the two became a unit. But understand this, in each situation, there are some prime things, and we're going to primarily focus on Neo, but then, you know, you'll see how Trinity comes in. See, in the first movie, the scene I want to focus on is when Neo went to go see the Oracle, right? The Oracle told him, you got the gift, but you're waiting for something, that you're not the one. And what she was saying is that it is not that he wasn't the one. It's that he is the one inside, but he's waiting for something to either tell him or convince him that he is the one. And it's not until that happens that he will actually become the one. Now, this is where Trinity starts to come in. He started to realize a little bit that he was the one when Trinity was in danger, when the helicopter was crashing, and he wrapped it around his arm and pulled it, and he shaped the world. At that moment, he started to realize, because the sacred heart, the feminine, the emotions were in danger. His love, his care was in danger. So in that situation, he started becoming the one. He started connecting and creating, okay? Now, we get to, in the second movie, you know, he's talking to the architect, and the architect is giving him a choice. Now, we have freedom of choice, right? And we can go into the Merovingian and causality and effect, but that's not part of this one. But I want to, but I'm not. This architect gives him the choice to either restart Zion and restart the process, save all of humanity, and that the machines were willing to live at certain levels of existence. But Trinity was in danger. His heart, again, was in danger. At this point, when he was flying through the city to go and save his heart, to save Trinity, to save his emotions, the care, when his will and his care were with each other, he flew so fast that that he wasn't even recognizable, that they didn't know what was going on, what was happening. The guys who was back on the Nebuchadnezzar were like, something's moving, it's moving faster than I ever seen, you know. He was creating again. Now, before I get to the third one, the thing about it is that throughout the first one and the second one and most of the third one, Trinity and Neo were at odds with each other on a lot of the things. He didn't want her coming into the Matrix in the second movie to save everybody, but because he had the dream. But she went anyway because she wanted to take care of him. You see, they was always at odds only because they were trying to take care of each other. And then in the first movie, she doubted him. She didn't know. She was told that she would fall in love with the one, but she wasn't sure. So, you know, that it was Neo, but she had emotions for him. So, you know, they had these moments where they were still kind of like, I want to take care of you by leading you, but not working with each other. They weren't in unison yet. Now, it is not until, okay, so at the end of the second one, again, Trinity is in danger when the machines throw a bomb, create a suicide bomb at the Nebuchadnezzar, blows it up, and then one of the sentinels is coming, but Neo's supposed to be in the real world, and in the real world, he stops the machine because he is now starting to understand that life itself, you can create and control, that you can go beyond the Matrix. Right, so he saved, but it's in an effort. He's saving himself and Trinity again, but it's mainly Trinity is with him. His heart, the sacred feminine, is there. In the third movie, it culminates with the fact that he asks for a single ship because he knows he has to go to the machine city, to the source, and that's how he can defeat Smith, who represents death. And so he's going to the machine city, but Trinity is saying that she has to go with him. That they have to be together. This is the one time the one time that they come in total unity with each other. So when the heart and the will, when the sacred feminine and the one, the divine inside you, come together, not trying to lead the other, but come together and working with each other in unity, is when you, Trinity sacrificed herself for the good of the two, and when Neo, the will, sacrificed himself and got up on his cross and created the salvation, that is when they all came together. That's when, although death thought that it had won, he actually destroyed death, and light was given. If you look, remember the last scene of Neo, he's in the cross light situation. There's a glow of light all around him, you know, as the machines take his body away, because he entered into the light. And that is how your mind has to work. Trinity representing the subconscious and your heart and your emotion, whereas Neo, the one, representing your conscious, your conscious mind. It is when the conscious and the subconscious and the conscious are together in unison that they think the same, they work the same, they are devoted to the same principle, the same task, the same level of creation. That is when you receive the glow. You know, Barry Gordy's Return of the Last Dragon, get the golden glow. You know, when you know that you know, when everything is in unison, you have a total glow. You know, not like Show Enough just had it on his hand. I know I went to a totally different movie right there. But you get what I'm saying, that you understand the point. The point is that your subconscious and your conscious has to work together, meaning that your will and your emotions, your heart, must work together in unison. And the only way to do that is not one pulling on the other. It is them both working together to bring love to one another, to bring understanding, to bring wisdom, to bring a level of knowledge to both, so that they are both moving in the same direction, so that your underlying thoughts are in unison with your conscious thoughts. And that's how you do it together. And if you want to do this with another person, which is even more difficult, because they have to have the same thing going on. I know people like to say, let's touch and agree on this or that, but you can touch and agree, but does that person truly, their underlying thought, is in agreement to what you're supposedly touching and agreeing on? You have to know that. So before a person says, let's touch and agree, before a person says, I'm going to pray for you about this, before a person says that we're going to do XYZ together, you really got to hammer down and nail it, you know, get it like concrete solid, that we are on the exact same vibration. Because there is absolutely no way your vibrations together will rise and you will create if you are on opposite poles, if your polarities are different. So you have to get that as close and in sync as possible. And if it's not, you're gonna have issues, you're gonna have problems. This is why the world has problems. Our vibrations are completely opposite of each other. We're on different poles of polarities with each other, because our heart and our mind, our subconscious, our conscious, our will, those things are fighting and battling, and one's trying to pull and rule the other instead of them working together. But if you want to create, if you want your family to be a certain way, your work to be a certain way, your company to be a certain way, then you have to create a situation that brings everybody together, brings the heart together, brings the will together, so that the mind, conscious, and subconscious is all working together. So, hey, like I always say, pour out your cup. Be willing to lose everything in order to gain everything. And my greatness is non-negotiable, just like I know yours is non-negotiable. Have a great day.